Hey guys, welcome to ELA. We're going to do things just a little bit different this week. We're not going to be at our reading book this week since we got a day behind. We don't have a whole week this week to get into another story and do all the activities. So it's Valentine's week, so I thought we would do some Valentine's review activities. So on your slides this week, you will need to turn them in. You don't usually turn in, you don't always have to turn in your slides, but in ELA this week, you will have some slides to turn in. So the first one you're going to see is called Advice from Cupid. So you've got this little text over here, and I want you to read this text. Then I've created some yellow boxes. Of course, all you have to do is click on the box and then start typing your answer, okay? Click on the box, start typing your answer. Two is a multiple choice. I put this little yellow circle. You're just going to click on the circle, and you're going to move it if you think the answer is B. Put it on B. If you think the answer is A, you'll put it on A, okay? So you'll move that little circle and put it where it goes. Here, just start typing. Here, start click on it and start typing. Here, click on it and start typing. So that's the first part that you'll need to do. Read the text first. And then you've got these little reading skills, hearts. And so we've got summarizing, critique, visualizing, analyzing, predicting. Summarizing's on there twice. That's okay. Infer, make connections, and synthesize. We've talked about all these, maybe except critique this year, but it tells you on one side what the word is. It tells you on the other side what the meaning of that word is. So you've got two slides with those, and then you're going to match. So you can go back up. So what does synthesize mean? I'm going to go back up here and look at the card. Synthesize, got to find it. To synthesize, when readers change their thinking because something new, they've learned the text. So I'm going to look over here. When readers change their thinking, D. So D is right there. So I would just click on number one and I would put D. And if it doesn't fit perfectly, it's okay. I can see that's a D. So don't stress out if it's not perfectly on the line. All right. And then after that, you've got your spelling list for this week. We are going to have a spelling test on Friday, and we're just going to do Valentine's word for this week. So there's 20 words, Cupid, balloons, card, chocolates, arrow, candy, flowers, bouquet, friendship, celebration, roses, sweetheart, love, happy Valentine's Day. I know that's three words, but that's one of our words this week. Heart, February, present, pink, purple, and red. So we'll do our spelling test like we always do. It'll be the choosing the multiple choice. After your spelling list, you've got a little story, kind of a Valentine's story called Somebody Loves You, Mr. Hatch. You're welcome to take an AR point to AR test on that as we work on getting our AR goal for February. And then you have one additional assignment, just spelling some plurals. So I've got an example for you up here. All of these words end in Y. They're kind of like our spelling test we just took from last week, which we took yesterday. They end in Y. So all of these, we're going to drop the Y to make them plural. We're going to add an I. So discovery turns into discoveries. Notice what we did. We drop the Y and add I-E-S. There's you a big clue. Drop the Y, add I-E-S. Every word is like that. There's your clue. But you've got to spell it correctly to get it right. There's only five words. They're worth 20 points each. So make sure you spell them correctly. Type carefully. Okay. All right, that's your ELA for today. Won't take you long to get it done, and I'll let you get started. See you tomorrow.